All right. Well, good morning. Shabbat Shalom, everyone. It's nice to have you with us for our Shabbat morning service. And let's open up with a quick word of prayer. Avinu Malkenu, our Father and our King, we come before you on this Shabbat, and we offer to you our prayer, our lives, that you would be honored by our worship of you this morning. Thank you, God, in the name of Yeshua. Amen. If you're at home and you'd like to participate, I welcome you if you'd like to stand for Matovu.
Matovu alecha Yaakov, mishkanotecha Israel. Matovu alecha Yaakov, Mishkanotecha Yisrael. Va'ani berov chasdecha avo betecha mishtach ve'alhech al kodshecha be'iratecha.
Well, good morning, everybody. Woo! We're going to have a good time, and we're going to say good morning, a good old-fashioned Hebrew way. Can you say shalom? Shalom! Here we go. Thank you, Gary. Gary's joining us today. You can actually see him. Are you ready, Sally?
Shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom. Shalom, shalom, sha, 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 shalom. Come and celebrate, rejoice in Adonai, come into the fullness of joy. As we drink the cup of gladness and leave behind our sadness, dancing in the presence of salvation. Shalom, shalom, we wish you the blessing of shalom. Shalom, shalom, sha, 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 shalom. This blessing unto you is special kind of peace, unlike the kind you might have heard about. There might be even more, but in the presence of the Lord, there is comfort in every situation. Shalom, shalom, we wish you the blessing of shalom. Shalom, shalom, sha, sha, shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom, 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 sha, 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 shalom. Shalom.
All right, well, turn to somebody in your little space there and say hello and say Shabbat Shalom. And make sure that you let them know that you're okay, because we're okay. Because the Lord says that he will surely lift us up as we become echad, even through this medium, as God draws us together and gives us the opportunity to be in his presence. That's what this next song is called and is all about, Ana Hashem. Is taken from Psalm 116:16, which says, O Lord, surely I am your servant. You have loosed my bonds.
Ana Hashem, Ana Hashem, ki ani avdecha
ki ani avdecha. Ani avdecha ben amotecha. Ani avdecha ben amotecha. Ani avdecha ben amotecha. Pitachta lemoserai. Ana Hashem. Ana Hashem, ki ani avdecha. Ana Hashem, ki ani avdecha. Ani avdecha, ben amotecha. Ben amotecha, ni avdecha. Ben amotecha, pitachta lemoserai. Yadadai. Thank you, God, for holding us together through the week, Lord, and using us to bring light to this world. Father, there's so much that we can say right now, but we are so eternally grateful for your Holy Spirit and so grateful for your love, God, that extends beyond our circumstances, touches us deeply, Lord, brings us hope and courage and encouragement. God, may we be so encouraged this morning as we ask for your Spirit to come. Bo Ruach Elohim, bo. Come, Holy Spirit of God. Lord, you are beautiful. Yeah. Your mercies abound. And you are to release your spirit now. And we are hungry to know you more. Stretch forth your hand to me. To you my heart restore. Fall on me, Holy Spirit of God. Fall on me. Fill my heart with your fire. Fall on me. You alone I desire. Come, Lord, fall on me. Quickly, Holy One, stretch forth your hand, bend down and lift me up, and breathe on me again. Stretch forth your hand to me, to you my heart restore.
So fall on me, yeah. Holy Spirit of God, fall on me. fill my heart with your fire. Fall on me. You alone I desire. Come, Lord, fall on me.
Come on, Gary. What do you have need of this morning? As the Holy Spirit falls on you, open your heart, receive what he has to give, and surrender all of it. We can do this. You can do this. Thank you, Lord.
For we are hungry to know. Stretch forth your hand to me. To you my heart restore. Fall on me, Holy Spirit of God. Fall on me. Fill my heart with your fire. Fall on me. You alone I do. Come, Lord, fall on me. Fall on me. Holy Spirit of God, fall on me. Fill my heart with your fire. Fall on me. You alone I desire. Come,
so I want to invite you to rise with us if you would like at home as we face the ark, wherever you are, for the barchu, the call to worship, as we call to one another into the deepest places and bless one another and call us forth to bless God together.
Barchu et Adonai HaMevorach. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Leolam
going to do the Yotzer Or. Anytime you're ready, Gary. Starting at the chorus. One, two, three, four.
Oh, chadash, al Zion ta'ir, or chadash, al Zion ta'ir, or chadash, al Zion ta'ir, or chadash, al Zion ta'ir. Benizke, benizke chulanu, mehera leoro. Benizke chulanu mehera leoro. Or chadash, or chadash, al Zion ta'ir.
And let's continue with the Shema. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Baruch Shem Kevo Malchuto Leolam Vaed.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one. Blessed be his name, whose glorious kingdom is forever and ever. And together with the Ve'ahavta in English, and you shall love Adonai your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. And these words which I command you today shall be upon your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall speak of them when you are sitting at home, and when you walk along the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign upon your hand, and fix them as an emblem upon your forehead. And you shall write them on the door of your house, and upon your gates. Amen.
Amen.
And now, Micha Mocha.
Ashir al Adonai ki ga'oga'a. Ashir al Adonai ki ga'oga'a. Micha Mocha ba'elim Adonai. Micha Mocha ne'eda. Ba'kodesh nachita v'chazdecha. Am zugalta nachita v'chazdecha. Am zugalta ashira, ashira, ashira. Ashira l'Adonai ki ga'oga'a. Ashira l'Adonai ki ga'oga'a. Mi kamocha ba'elim Adonai. Mi kamocha ne'eda. Ba'kodesh nachita v'chazdecha. Am zugalta nachita v'chazdecha. Am zugalta ashira, ashira, ashira. Ashira, ashira, ashira.
Ashira, I will sing. Amen. So now we prepare ourselves for the Amidah, the standing prayer. And like usual, we will do the first three blessings together. And then there will be a time for silent meditation. If you have a siddur at home, you can either follow along and pray from a siddur, or you can just use that quiet time to pray whatever it is that you would like to speak out to God this morning.
Adonai Svatai Tiftachu Fi Yagi Tehilatecha. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Ve'elohei Avoteinu Ve'imoteinu Elohei Avraham Elohei Yitzchak Ve'elohei Yaakov Elohei Sara Elohei Rivka Elohei Rachel Ve'elohei Lea Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor Vahanora El Elyon Gomel Chasadim Tovim Ve'konei Hakol Ve'zocher Hasdei Avot Ve'imahot Umevi Goel Livne Venehem Lema'an Shemo Be'ahava Melech Ozer U'Moshia U'Magen
Baruch atah Adonai, Magen Avraham ufoked Sarah. Ata gibor leolam Adonai, mechaye metim ata, rav lehoshia. Mechalkel chayim bechesed, mechaye metim barachamim rabim, somech noflim verofe cholim, umatir asurim. Kayem emunato lishene afar michamocha ba'agvurot umidomelach melech memit umchaye umatzmiach yeshua ve'ne'manata lehachayot metim. Baruch atah Adonai, mechaye hametim.
Advance the slide, please. We shall sanctify your name in this world, just as it is sanctified in heaven above. According to the words of your prophet, one called to another, saying,
Kadosh, 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 Adonai Tzevaot, Meloch Kol Haaretz Kvodo.
Then with a loud, thundering voice, rising to face the seraphim, they say,
Baruch Kvod Adonai Mimkomo.
From your dwelling place, you will appear and reign over us.
When will you reign in Sion?
Soon and in our days may you dwell there. May you be highly exalted and sanctified in the midst of Jerusalem, your holy city. From generation to generation and for all eternity, may our eyes witness your kingdom as it is written by the hand of your servant David, your righteous anointed.
Yimloch Adonai le'olam, Elohayich Tzion, l'dor v'dor, Alleluia.
We shall proclaim your greatness throughout every generation, and for all eternity we shall declare your holiness. Your praise, our God, shall never leave our lips, for you are a great and holy King.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the holy God.
We now continue silently in meditation and prayer.
Osei shalom bimromah, uya'asei shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael.
We now take a moment to pray for all of our friends and loved ones, our family members who need a prayer of healing at this time, whether it's healing physically, emotionally, spiritually, whatever it is. So there'll be a moment where you can add the names of those you would like mentioned. And if you're able to participate and follow along, please recite this prayer with me. May the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, may he bless and heal all those who are suffering illness. Let's continue together. May the Holy One be filled with compassion for them in order to return them to full health and vigor and send them a quick and full recovery from heaven, healing of body and mind, together with all others who are ill in the community of Israel and the congregation of Messiah. For Shabbat is a time of healing in the merit of Yeshua. May healing come speedily and soon. And let us say, Amen. So now it is time for our very abbreviated Torah service. So if you will recite with me the blessing for scripture study. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu la'asok b'divrei Torah. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who brought holiness into our lives through the mitzvot and has commanded us to busy ourselves with words of Torah. And so our opening reading from Leviticus. This week we have a double portion, Acharei Mot and Kedoshim.
Okay.
Come over to this one.
Okay. All right. Today's reading is from Vayikra, Leviticus 16, 1 and 2. Adonai spoke with Moshe after the death.
It's not on, I don't think.
It is.
Where?
It is?
Okay. It's on. Okay. Adonai spoke with Moshe after the death of Aharon's two sons when they tried to sacrifice before Adonai and died. Adonai said to Moshe, "Tell your brother Aharon not to come at just any time into the holy place beyond the curtain in front of the ark cover, which is on the ark, so that he will not die, because I appear in the cloud over the ark cover."
And we have the reading for the Haftarah portion this morning from Amos, chapter 9, verses 11 through 12. "In that day, I will raise up David's fallen sukkah. I will restore its breaches, raise up its ruins, and rebuild it as in days of old, so they may possess the remnant of Edom and all the nations called by my name. It is a declaration of Adonai, the one who will do this."
And the Brit Hadashah reading today is from Matthew, chapter 19, verses 1 and 2. "Now when Yeshua had finished these words, he moved on from Galilee and entered the region of Judea beyond the Jordan. Large crowds followed him, and he healed them there."
Amen. And also, we're in this period of the counting of the Omer between Passover and Shavuot. And so today is the 23rd day of the Omer, which is 3 weeks and 2 days of the Omer. Well, Shabbat Shalom, everyone. This week, we have a double header for a Torah portion. It's a doubled up Parsha, which is Acharei Mot and Kedoshim. Often throughout the year, when we have shorter years in readings, then there are Torah portions that are doubled up. And when we have longer years, then they're all spread out. That's a whole other conversation that we're not going to get into. But both of these themes echo themes of death, but also acts of holiness. The beginning Torah portion this week of our doubleheader is Acharei Mot. And it begins by saying, after the death of Aaron's two sons, which we encountered in last week's Torah portion. And then it goes on to discuss forbidden sexual relationships. And then we move on to Parashat Kedoshim, which is an entire Torah portion focused on holiness. When one first looks at our Torah portions this week, at a quick glance, they seem to be just a long list of do's and don'ts. If so, why is there so much talk about holiness and being holy? What is the connection? Parashat Kedoshim begins with these words, Vayidaber Adonai el Moshe Lemor, and Hashem spoke to Moses saying, Deber el kol edat b'nei Yisrael, and speak unto the whole congregation of the children of Israel, Kedoshim tihiyu, you shall be holy, for I, the Lord, your God, am holy. Parashat Kedoshim is one of my favorite parashiyot in all of the Torah. Why? Because it clearly illustrates the stark distinction between the concept of holiness as understood within Judaism and the way that it is understood within the rest of the Western world. Holiness in the Torah is not some mystical, esoteric state of being that somehow we're all striving to attain. Instead, it is rather a state of being, a way of living our lives. In the Torah, holiness is establishing God's kingdom and presence here on this earth. It is partnering with God and bringing redemption into the world. In theological parlance, in theological language, we can call this proleptic living. That from the Greek word prolepsis, which means an expectation that we live with one foot in the kingdom and one foot in the here and now. And what we do affects what happens in the heavenly realms, and that we are living now in realization for the Messianic age. And in fact, that's what one of my heroes, the great Jewish believer of the late 1800s, early 1900s, Paul Philip Levertov says, is it is the big business of the chassid, the business of a pious individual to live now for the realization of this Messianic age. The Torah portion is called Kedoshim because it is all about holiness. It is the instructions for how to live a life that is holy and pleasing unto God. We are instructed to weigh fairly, pursue justice, observe Shabbat and the mitzvot, and protect those who are downtrodden. Why? Because the Torah states, Anochi Hashem, that I am Hashem, and you are to be holy because I am holy. It is a concept radically different from many of our own understandings of what we perceive as holy. Holiness is establishing God's presence in the here and now among us and through us. This is exactly what Yeshua modeled and taught us to pray for, especially when he, in the prayer known as the Lord's Prayer, Tefillat Adon, in the line where it says, Tavo malchutecha yaseh ratzoncha ba'aretz, may your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth just as it is in heaven. In the Torah, kingdom principles are not just mystical or esoteric. They are practical and establish God's presence here in the earth. That is why our Torah portion deals primarily with matters of relationship, how we treat and respond to one another and look out for one another, which includes matters of justice. This is exactly what Yeshua modeled and taught. Yeshua came to serve and to ransom his life for ours. That is why in this week's Torah portion, we also find the commandment echoed by Yeshua himself, Ve'ahavta l'ra'icha kamocha, you shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. Loving your neighbor is a substantive command to demonstrate tangible acts toward all people, regardless of their geographic or relational proximity to you. Why? Simply because all people are created, the Torah says, B'tzelem Elohim, created in the image of God. Holiness, according to the Torah, is a way of life. It is a lifestyle directed outward. This is why we serve others. For example, why Helping Hands distributes hundreds of pounds of food each week from our congregation or within the parameters of our congregation, or why we even participate in things like the Walk to End Genocide. So much of what we do and who we are is supposed to be directed outwards. As I've mentioned so many times before, it all boils down to two things: our love for God and our love for one another. Everything else is commentary. But what does that kind of love really mean? Are we supposed to walk around with warm, fuzzy feelings all the time? It'd be nice, but not exactly. To understand the Bible's use of the word love, we need to understand the context in which it is used. In the Bible, love is covenantal language. It is more than a feeling. It is a commitment. It's a verb, an action. You do this, and this is what will happen. And when you don't do this, this is what will happen. When the Torah tells us to love God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, and with all of our might, it means we are to follow God, adhere to the mitzvot, and live in covenant obedience, whether or not we feel like it. Loving God is a commitment to follow God even when we don't feel like it, and even when we doubt. Many of you know that in all of your relationships, no matter what kind of a relationship it is, whether it's a romantic relationship, whether it's with your parents, with other loved ones, with friends, is that there are times you just don't feel it in the relationship. There are times in which you doubt the relationship. Are they really my friend? Am I still really in love with this person? But that kind of a commitment and that kind of a relationship requires that you continue the commitment of the relationship regardless of whether you feel it. That's what everybody always says, right? Once you've been married for a long time, for example, you don't always have warm, fuzzy feelings, but that doesn't mean that there's not love within the relationship. I'm not saying that a relationship devoid of any warm, fuzzy feelings ever is probably not a good thing. But warm, fuzzy feelings only get you so far. After a while, true love is built on something that is much bigger than emotions and feelings. Last week, I did an interview for a podcast with Jewish Voice Ministries regarding the counting of the Omer and this time that we're in leading up to Shavuot. And we were talking about the idea of waiting with participation, right? Waiting with anticipation is what I meant to say. Waiting with anticipation. It is preparing ourselves with expectation. That we're in this time of the counting of the Omer when it seems like even with what we're doing right now with the current pandemic that we're in is we're supposed to just go home and wait, right? What is that really supposed to mean? But that's not what the Torah tells us to do. As the Torah says, we're supposed to count with anticipation up to Shavuot. It's interesting that we don't count down, right? Instead, we count up. It's 1, 2, 3, all the way up to the 50th day in anticipation for what God is going to do on Shavuot, in which we celebrate not only the original outpouring of, or the giving of the Torah, but then what happened in Acts chapter 2 on Shavuot with the outpouring of the Spirit. That is so relevant right now, that we can either be sitting at home, missing everything that is normal, and you know, and trust me, even I do that, often wanting things to get back to normal. But we also have an opportunity to prepare ourselves for what God wants to do in and through what is happening right now. We need to be counting with anticipation for what God could be doing, not only within us and preparing ourselves for Shavuot and what lies ahead, but also for what God wants to do in the world. Let us pray for the inspiration and strength to lead lives that are holy and pleasing to God, that are directed outward to serving God and serving others. May each one of us pursue justice, follow Torah, and protect those downtrodden, because that's what we've been called to do. Because if you read the text carefully, if you read the scriptures carefully, it all boils down to just two things: loving God, loving one another, the rest is commentary. Avinu Shebashamayim, our Father in heaven, I pray, God, that you would use this time that we have often lots of time on our hands, or we're so busy, but we would take a moment to really think about what you would want us to get out of this period of the counting of the Omer, this time in which we're in quarantine, the time that we're sequestered. What is it that you want to be doing in us and through us? Often, you did the greatest things in people in scripture when they went off, out into the desert or wherever it was by themselves where they encountered you. In this time of the counting of the Omer, when we're living in anticipation for what you want to pour out on Shavuot, I pray, God, that we would be preparing ourselves for what you want to do in us and through us. God, I don't want to just come out on the other side of not only Shavuot, but of this pandemic and everything to just be normal. I want to move beyond normal. I want to see amazing things happening. I want to see your kingdom come, your will be done on earth just as it is in heaven. And that starts with me. It starts with us. It starts with just our little congregation. But we pray that that would then spill out into the world, that you would quicken others. And I know you are already doing that for the same prayer and the same heart's desire. To see your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hashem, our God, open our eyes for opportunities to serve you and help us to see the world and our neighbors the way you see them. And may we all merit your soon coming and the ultimate redemption of the Messianic age. We pray this B'Shem Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of Yeshua our Messiah. Amen. So now I'd like to invite Brett up here. He has just a couple of announcements. And those who in our community who are watching from Zoom, you can stay on as usual as we connect with one another, pray with one another. And there will be some other specific announcements related just to our congregation. But
Shabbat Shalom, everyone. This would be really the time when we, before the Eleinu, when we ask all of you to consider giving to Beth Emunah. There are many ways to give. The one right behind me, actually right in front of you, is Venmo. And that is the easiest and most popular way to give. Also, you can write your checks and have them delivered by mail. And again, you can also go to bethemunah.org and give there. Also, I wanted to thank the Helping Hands Ministry. I don't know how many of you are aware of what is happening with Helping Hands, but every Thursday afternoon between 12 and 1, we have been giving food away to the Beth Emunah congregation, to those who are in desperate need of it during this time of uncertainty. What we're going to be doing in the future, hopefully, is going to be extending that to the community. There will be more involved in that, and there will be more details as we get along to it. But I just wanted to thank everyone that is involved with Helping Hands Ministry who's been able to provide meals for our congregation and for those who are in need. So Shabbat Shalom, everyone, and look forward to seeing you again here soon.
A huge thank you to all of you who volunteer with Food Share. As you know, we collect hundreds of pounds of food each week, and that is delivered out to other organizations, other groups, and then what is left over then are these food boxes that Brett was just mentioning. And so thank you. That's a huge, not only work that we're doing within the synagogue, but it's a holy work as well. So with that, we're going to begin to close our service, and we'll begin with the Eleinu. So I want to invite you, if you're at home, to rise with us.
Aleinu leshabeach la'adon hakol, latet gedula leyotzer breshit, shelo asanu kegoye ha'aratzot, velo samanu kemishpechot ha'adama, shelo sam chelkenu kahem, vegoralenu kechol hamonam. Va'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'modim lifne melech mache hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu shehu note shamayim ve'yoser aretz u'moshav yikaro bashamayim mima'al u'shechinatu zo Begav he meromim, hu Eloheinu ein od, emet malkeinu efezulato, kakatu betohato veyadata hayom veyadata hayom vehashavota elevavacha ki Adonai hu ha-Elohim bashamayim mima'al ve'al ha'aretz ve'al ha'aretz mitachat ein od.
Therefore God also highly exalted Messiah and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name belonging to Yeshua every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Yeshua the Messiah is Adonai, to the glory of God the Father.
V'ne'emar v'haya Adonai l'melech al kol ha'aretz b'yom ha'hu b'yom ha'hu yihye Adonai echad u'shemo 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 echad.
Amen. And now as we prepare for the Mourner's Kaddish, I want to quickly just mention the passing of Karem Delgado's aunt, Norma Bat Shimona, who passed away this week. And so our hearts and prayers go out to the Delgado family during this difficult time of mourning. So I want to invite those who are in mourning and those observing a yard site, as we also just want to mention, to continue to pray for and stand in support and love of the Hudding family as well. So please join me in the Mourner's Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitkadash shemei rabba, be'alma divra chirute v'yamlich mochute, v'yitzmach porkane v'karem shiche, b'chayachon v'yomechon, uv'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, ba'agala v'zman karim v'imru, amen. Yehe shmei rabba mevorach le'olam ulalmei ulmaya, Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh, v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shmei d'kudisha b'richu, le'ela minko birchata v'shirata, tushbechata v'nechemata, damiran b'alma v'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim alenu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Ose shalom bimromav, hu ya'ase shalom, alenu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. May he who makes peace in the heavenly realms make peace for all of us, for all of Israel and all the nations of the world. And let us say, amen. And now with our closing benediction.
Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmarecha. Ya'er Adonai p'nav eilecha v'chuneicha. Yisa Adonai p'nav eilecha. Vayasem lecha uwa. Shalom.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and fill you and us and this entire world with peace. Amen. Well, Shabbat Shalom, everyone. I want to remind you to join us again here, either on Facebook Live or on Zoom at 2 o'clock p.m. today for our virtual Beit Midrash, where we'll be discussing the weekly, going deeper into this week's Parashiyot. Also, just one last thing is that Most of you have heard of Giving Tuesday. Well, the organization that organizes that during this time of COVID and to support nonprofit organizations is doing Giving Tuesday now, which is May 5th. It's on this coming Tuesday. And so we will also be launching a campaign. And I want to ask you to continue to support the work that is happening here at Beth Emunah, because even though we're virtual and even though we're in this midst of this pandemic, there's still actually we have much more happening now than we usually do. It's just that it's not happening from the sanctuary here. It's happening outside of here. It's happening in your homes. It's happening on your screens. It's happening with the food that we continue to distribute and the other work that we do. So thank you, everybody, for participating. Shabbat Shalom. For those on Zoom, go ahead and stay on the call, and we'll meet for our usual discussion and prayer. Shabbat Shalom.